Undiscovered Country by Tom Stoppard, based on the original play by Arthur Schnitzler, with Ronald Pickup as Friedrich Hofreiter, Maureen O'Brien as his wife Gania, John Rowe as Dr. Mauer, Elizabeth Proud as Mrs. Vahl, and Maxine Audley as Mrs. von Eichner. The action of the play takes place in Austria, shortly before the First World War. Undiscovered Country.
So you have come to bury me, to say goodbye to Alexei Korsakov. More rain than tears, though, it would seem. And anger, too, on the face of Friedrich Hofreiter. Well, death must have its day, and this is no more than a trick played against the calendar. Farewell, Gania. Don't you be angry with me. Perhaps it's better that you turned aside, my love. We were not made for deceit. At least, you were not, even if I was. And now I know why you won't leave him, in spite of everything. You love him, Gania, and that's the end of the mystery. You still love your husband. Your rejection of me, your loving Alexei. Your fidelity is no more than the hope that one day he will be yours again. I'm sorry, Gania, but I could not live without you.
Herr Hofreiter will no doubt have taken tea in town.
Yes, thank you, Cathy.
It's turned quite cold out here in the conservatory, madam. Would you like me to bring something to put around you?
Thank you. Tell me, Cathy, who is that in the garden there?
It looks like Madame Vahl and her daughter. They're coming this way. The funeral must be over, madam.
Yes. You're right, it has become quite cold.
I'll fetch you something straight away.
Thank you, Cutty. My white shawl, I think.
Yes, madam. Gania!
Come in, both of you. Safely back.
Yes, safely back. But the weather was terrible. Is it all right if we sit down for a moment?
Oh, of course, please.
God, the rain. Oh. I thought it would never stop.
It rained here until an hour ago.
Well, you did right to stay at home.
We nearly drowned at the cemetery, didn't we, Mama?
We did. But please remember, it was you, Anna, who made me go.
I didn't know it was going to be like that.
A church service would have been quite sufficient. What good does it do anyone, after all?
It certainly didn't bring poor Korsakov back to life.
Were there many there?
Oh, tout le monde. The Natters were there, rolled up in their new motor, the red one.
It's seen all over the place, I hear.
Well, it certainly brightened up the funeral.
Your shawl, madam.
Oh, thank you. Cutty, dear, that will be all.
Yes, madam.
I'm afraid I'm feeling the chill. Oh. Now, did you speak to Friedrich out there?
Only in passing.
He was quite upset.
I'm not surprised.
Well, I was. He doesn't usually let things upset him easily.
You seem to know him quite well.
Why not? I've loved him since I was seven. Loved him before you did, Frau Gania.
Oh, Frau Gania, am I?
Gania.
Friedrich was very fond of Alexei Korsakov, you know.
Well, obviously. And there was I thinking that Korsakov was just his pianist.
His pianist?
Well, as Dr. Maurer is his best friend, Mr. Natter his banker, myself his partner for tennis, Captain Stanzides for duels.
Duels?
So I thought Korsakov was Friedrich's pianist. take from each according to your needs. That's Friedrich's idea of a social order.
And there goes Erna out on her psychological limb, as my late husband used to say. Ah, Lieutenant.
Good evening.
Good evening, Lieutenant von Eigner. Won't you come in for a moment?
With your permission, Mum. Mum.
Lieutenant. How is your mama? We haven't seen her today.
My mother has gone into town. She has a performance tonight.
We went to Korsakoff's funeral.
Of course. Does anybody know why he killed himself?
No.
Someone at the funeral said they thought it was an artistic tantrum.
They thought what?
Well, he was forever being told he could only play Chopin and Schumann, but not Beethoven or Bach.
It seems a bit excessive, though. Didn't he leave a note?
Korsakoff wouldn't be seen dead with a suicide note.
There she goes again.
He was far too intelligent and he had too much taste. He understood what it means to be dead and cared nothing for what people might make of it next morning.
I read in the papers that on the evening he killed himself, he was dining with friends in excellent spirits.
The papers always say that.
This time it happens to be true. My husband was one of the friends with whom he died.
Oh, well.
Friedrich was working late at the factory, so he decided to stay in town at the apartment.
Oh.
He dined with Korsakoff at the Imperial Hotel and... Mm-hmm. Afterwards, they adjourned to the cafe for a game of billiards.
Just your husband and Korsakoff?
Yes. They even had a bet together for a box of cigars. And Friedrich lost. Next morning, he sent Josef, his manservant, round from the flat with the cigars and... Didn't you know?
No.
It was Josef who made the discovery.
And what happened?
Well, he went to Korsakoff's room at the Imperial, knocked a few times. No reply, so... Finally, he opened the door and...
There lay Korsakoff. Dead?
Yes. With the revolver still in his hand.
Mm. Awful moment for the manservant.
Yes.
What did he do with the cigars? Did he leave them?
Mama believes in historical precision.
That's Friedrich's car now. I'm sure it is.
It's stopping here.
Oh, good. We can arrange a game of tennis straight away.
Do you think he'll be in the mood for a game of tennis?
Well, why not? When it's my turn to go, people can practice forehands against my gravestone if they like. Come on, let's go and meet him.
Good evening, everybody.
Oh, it's you, Dr. Mull.
My compliments, Genia. Mm. Good evening, Mrs. Vile.
Doctor.
Ah, Miss Erna.
Doctor.
Good evening. Lieutenant.
Doctor.
Friedrich is working late. I've just come to return his car, which he was kind enough to lend me to visit a couple of patients I've got out here.
Is he staying the night in town?
No, he's coming on by train. I thought he might be here already.
Alas, we can't wait. I hope we'll see you soon, Shane New, Doctor. Although, thank God, we enjoy perfect health.
You must come soon, though, Doctor. We're off to the mountains in 2 weeks or so, to Lake Foss.
Mm. Well, then there's a chance we'll meet in the mountains. The fact is, I'm also being drawn to the Dolomites. Oh. It would be fun if you were there, too.
Oh, I'd love to go climbing again. Well, Mama, time to go.
Oh, yes, indeed. Lieutenant, will you come with us part of the way?
Yes, delighted, of course, yes. Oh, goodbye, Mum.
Lieutenant.
Please give my respects to your husband.
Yes.
Goodbye, Genia. Yeah? Auf Wiedersehen, Doctor.
Auf Wiedersehen. Auf Wiedersehen. Looking at the daughter, one could almost forgive the mother.
A son-in-law could do a lot worse than Mrs. Vile. I should think it over, Doctor.
I don't believe I cut enough of a dash for Erna.
Let's stroll in the garden, shall we?
So Friedrich is working late.
Yes. I was meant to tell you he had to wait for an important telegram from America.
Yes?
Yes, really. About that business of a patent for his improved electric light. He's got a meeting with his banker tomorrow.
With Mr. Natter?
Natter is his banker.
They were at the funeral too, I hear. The Natters?
Yes.
The red motor car made an impression.
So, it's red. So. By the way... Your husband's affair with Mrs. Natter is over.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
That's good. Did Friedrich tell you himself?
Oh, no, he wouldn't. But my diagnosis rarely calls for a second opinion. In all honesty, there was never any cause to take it too seriously. Adela Natter is very flighty.
Oh, yes, she's harmless. I'm not worried by her at all. But I think Mr. Natter, for all his friendly manner... is a brutal man. I wouldn't like to cross him. And sometimes I've been afraid for Friedrich. Like a mother worrying about a son, a rather grown-up son, who's got himself into some scrape. Do you know what I mean?
Well, yes, of course. All good wives are mothers to their husbands.
I haven't always felt like that. More than once I thought of leaving him.
Oh?
Once I even thought of killing myself. But that was a long time ago. And perhaps it only seems like that to me now.
Quite so. When it came to the point, you'd never have inconvenienced Friedrich by killing yourself.
You think I'm considerate? You're quite wrong. There was even a time when I thought of inconveniencing Friedrich, as only a wife can. I wanted revenge.
Revenge?
Well, let's say I wanted to get even.
Well, never mind. Perhaps fate has it in store for you.
I don't have to rely on fate.
But you will, alas. My sense of justice has long been affronted by the way my old friend Friedrich gets off scot-free.
Oh, Friedrich pays. Not in the same coin, but he pays all right. No, sometimes I even feel sorry for him. I really think he has a demon driving him. Oh, hello, Friedrich.
Good evening. Hello, Ma.
Hello there, Friedrich.
Good evening, Genya. How are you? Do you want to come to America?
No. Do you want some tea?
No. I had tea at the office. What a downpour that was. Did you have it out here? The cemetery was awash. What with the rain and the tears, we were ankle deep. We were well out of it. Well, Ma, did the motor behave itself? How fast did you drive? 10 miles an hour, what? Prudent to a fault, that's you.
That's me, but I really must be going.
Oh, why did you stay?
I have to be early at the hospital.
Superstitious, Ma.
Why?
Well, I thought perhaps you didn't want to spend the night in our guest room since poor Korsakov slept there a week ago. But I don't think the dead are allowed out round their old haunts on their very first night.
How can you talk like that?
You're right. It's really awful. A week ago, he slept up there, and the evening before, he played the piano for us. Chopin. A nocturne in C-sharp minor. Something by Schumann. And we sat on the veranda there. Otto was here, too. And the Natters. Who would have dreamed? If only one had an idea. Why? Genya, didn't he say anything to you either?
Me?
Well, artists are all more or less unhinged, aren't they? For one thing, the way they take themselves so seriously, desperate for recognition, acclaim, applause. It disturbs the balance of the mind, all that banking on immortality.
What are you talking about? You didn't even know him. None of you knew him. Applause? Korsakov? No, he'd got that handsome head screwed on all right. Bashing the ivories was just something to do. Do you know what he was really interested in? He had Kant and Schopenhauer and Nietzsche at his fingertips and Marx and Proudhon. He was amazing. 27 years old. Kills himself. Dear God, a fellow like that with so much before him. Young, famous. With that profile, too. He shoots himself. If it was some old fool for whom life has nothing more to offer. And the evening before, there we were, sitting down to supper with a man like that, smoking, playing billiards with him. What is it, Genya? What is there to smile about?
I'm thinking about Mrs. Vahl. Huh? She wanted to know what became of his cigar.
She's really priceless. My manservant brought them back to me, of course. Look, here in my pocket. Oh, have one, Doctor. Korsakov has given them up.
Oh, thank you.
Allow me.
Well, I'll be off to town.
Oh, should I drive you to the station?
No, I've time to walk, and it's safer. Goodbye to you both. Oh, my cigar's died on me. I kiss your hand, my dear, and take my leave.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Perhaps my cigar's gone to its rightful owner.
What was that about America? Were you serious?
Of course. Well, wouldn't you like to, Genya?
No. But I was thinking, while you're over there, I could go to England. Stay with Joey.
Where did this notion suddenly come from?
It's not so sudden. And since you seem determined to let our son stay over there for years to come...
Well, you can see how famously he's getting on. It'd be damned selfish to interrupt all that cricket, character building, bring him back here where they educate you in every kind of sentimental brutality.
If it wasn't for missing him so...
Well, yes, of course. Oh, perhaps you think I don't miss him. Oh, but in my opinion, separation is good for relationships. Only by missing people does one learn their value. In an ideal world, more and more people would see less and less of each other. Anyway, we can go back with Joey to England, and you can decide then if you want to come with me or stay with the boy through the winter.
I'd rather you took it as final.
Final? Look, what's the matter with you, Genya? You're behaving very oddly.
Am I?
Yes. You are. Have you noticed the roses have no scent at all this year? I don't know why it is. Every year they look more gorgeous, but they've stopped bothering.
Let's go indoors. I'm feeling cold again.
Just as well you didn't go to the funeral, Genya. What with the drivel and the drizzle. I must say that when the coffin was lowered into the grave, the sun came out. Isn't it Thursday today? He was going to have supper with us. Here, let me have a look at Joey's card.
He'll be here in 4 weeks.
Well, top in Greek. Not too bad. Perhaps he'll be a philologist. Or an archaeologist. By the way, did you see the article in the Times yesterday about the excavations in Crete?
No.
Very interesting.
Why? Did they dig up a light bulb?
Tell me something, Genya.
What?
I was wondering whether perhaps you knew why Korsakov shot himself.
You know, I was just as surprised as you were.
Well, tell me why you want to leave me. At a moment's notice.
I don't want to leave you. I want to visit my son. And not at a moment's notice, but in the autumn.
Yes, otherwise it would almost look as if you were running away.
I'm under no such necessity. We could hardly be further apart than we are.
Look, Genya, he's dead and buried. Alexei Korsakov is dead and buried.
Then I suggest you stop digging him up.
Now, don't get excited, my darling. Calm at all costs. I'm only trying to say that it... can't make the slightest difference to him now if you were to tell me that. Oh, no, not that anything would happen to him if he were still alive, of course. No more than to you. Don't misunderstand me, Genya. Nothing much need have happened between you. It could have been just a flirtation. Yes. Because if there had been anything more to it, why shoot himself? Unless there was more to it. And you ended it.
You ought to take something for your nerves, Friedrich. I don't know... But I can't help it if Adela Natter is finished with you. And you haven't yet found a replacement.
Well, you are well informed, and I won't inquire as to the source. Besides, it's not my fault that you never asked me straight out. I wouldn't have told you you ought to take something for your nerves. That isn't like you at all. I really don't understand you. It's as though you didn't trust me. No, I promise you, I don't think I'm being devious. I would understand completely. You can't imagine how unimportant certain things become when you've just left a cemetery. So come. Well, tell me. If it's true, I'll find out anyway. Was Alexei Korsakov your lover?
No. Unfortunately, no. Does that satisfy you?
Unfortunately. Now, if you say that, you must have loved him. And if you loved him, what was there to stop you? And when you put an end to it, he killed himself.
Oh, excuse me.
I watched him when he played. When he was here the other night, he played Chopin. He played for you, didn't he? Why did you put an end to it? Perhaps you thought as well sooner as later. And Joey was coming home from school and you wanted to feel... How should I put it? Unsullied. Well, it's all very respectable, all very clear so far. Except for this idea about a trip to England. No! Come to that. That makes sense too.
Stop it!
You can't think that I... that I would... Read that. Read it.
What's this? A letter? A letter from him? No, you keep it. I don't want
it. I insist that you read it.
Anyway, there's no need. You can tell me what's in it. It could well be in Russian. And in tiny handwriting, one could do irreparable damage to one's eyesight.
Read it.
Farewell, Genya. When did you get the letter?
An hour before you brought the news of his death.
So when I came home, you already knew. I'm just... Well, at the risk of your thinking me a complete idiot, I didn't notice a thing, not a thing. Farewell, Genya. Please do not be angry with me. Death must have its day. Perhaps it was as well you turned aside my importunate love, for we were not made for deceit. At least you were not, even if I was. And apart from that, I know why you won't leave him. You love him, Genya. There, at an end of the mystery, you still love your husband in spite of everything. In spite of everything? You must have complained about me a good deal. You love Friedrich, and that's the reason for your rejection of me. Your loving Alexei. I can't read this word.
Fidelity.
Thank you. Your fidelity is no more than the hope that one day he will be yours again. I'm sorry, Genya, but I could not live without you.
That's his interpretation. You know I hope for nothing. And want nothing.
Would you have said yes if you'd known it was a matter of life or death?
What if I'd known? How could one ever know?
But surely you do reproach yourself that you drove him to kill himself.
I'm sorry he's dead, but what should I reproach myself for? My fidelity.
Please. Tell me you would have said yes if you'd known. Would you? I see. There's your letter. Now, excuse me.
Oh, this isn't my game. I hope there's nothing at stake.
You're thinking of Korsakov? Don't worry. Not even a cigar, Doctor.
Yes, poor Korsakov.
Oh, by the way, it's probably just as well that you didn't stay in our guest room the other night. The chances of a ghostly apparition in my house have considerably increased.
What?
Well, actually, you don't deserve my confidence. You blurt out everything you know, even things I never told you.
What do you mean?
Well, how else did Genya find out that I finished my affair with Adela Nutter?
You ought to be thankful that for once it's possible to say something to your credit. What was that about a ghost?
What? Oh, that. Well, Korsakov left a letter for my wife. She made me read it. Quite a remarkable letter, not at all badly written. For a Russian. And why do you think he killed himself? Go on, have a guess. Because of a hopeless love. For my wife. Yes.
a hopeless love. Now, we know that there is such a thing.
I'd like to get away from Vienna.
Well, why don't you stay at home in Baden for a while?
I'd like to get away from Baden, especially. When are you going to the mountains?
I'm taking the express on Sunday morning. I'm going to spend a few days walking, and I'll end up at the hotel at Lake Falls.
At the Vols Hotel? Aren't Mrs. Vahl and her daughter going to be there?
Coincidence.
Or fate? You and Ella Vahl will be quite a match. Well, dear chap, do your best. I wouldn't let anybody have a... Anyway, come out to Baden to see us before you leave.
Some lemonade with my compliments, Mrs. Natter.
Ah, Captain Stanzidi, so you've arrived. Do you know Paul Kindle? This is Captain Stanzidi's. Mr. Kindle comes to make up a four. Captain Stanzidi's likewise, though we're not sure yet what his game is, are we, Adela?
I'm afraid I'm not much of a partner for Mrs. Natter. Perhaps you should take up tennis, Captain.
I think I'm well occupied serving lemonade. Excuse me.
Frau Genia, when is your son coming home from England?
In 2 weeks, Mrs. Natter. And then perhaps you might like to bring your children along to play with
me. I'd love to, if you'd let me. And if Joey isn't too old now to want to bother with my two little ones.
Of course he is.
When did you show up, Doctor?
When you missed that lob, I thought you were waving at me.
Well, I'm glad you came. When do you leave for the mountains?
Tomorrow.
And when will Anna and myself have the pleasure of welcoming you to Lake Vols?
In a week or so, if that's all right.
Of course it is. You'll be able to meet my son, Gustl. Hmm. We've made a rendezvous at the Lake Vols Hotel. He's been travelling out in the east.
Will you take me with you, Ma?
You want to come climbing? I thought you'd given up climbing since...
Oh, surely you're not being superstitious again. All that happened 7 years ago. And it was the only time it ever happened.
What? What happened?
Oh, a tragic accident. Oh. My companion slipped on the rock and fell right past me and was dead when he hit the ground. Oh. That was poor Dr. Bernhardt.
It has to be said, you're not very lucky with your friends.
So it was you who was on that climb?
You heard about it, Lieutenant von Aigner?
Well, naturally. It happened on the Aigner-Turm, which my father was the first to climb more than 20 years
That's
ago.
That's right, it was the Aigner-Turm.
One quite forgets it was named after a man who's still alive.
Oh, well, Lieutenant, it must be an extraordinary feeling to know that there is a mountain in the Dolomites to which you are, in a sense, related.
Not really. Both the mountain and my father are more or less strangers to me. I was a boy of 4 or 5 when my parents separated, and I haven't seen him since.
Forgive me. It was thoughtless of me.
Oh, that's all right.
Well, Otto, we shall soon be acquainted with your father. We hear he's taken over the directorship of the new hotel.
That's right. And apparently all the ladies are in a spin over him, despite his grey hair.
That will do, Mama.
Anna.
I am off to play singles with Pa.
Well, tell him to watch out for your backhand return. Remember, you learned it from me.
Yes, by avoiding your example.
Would you like some lemonade? Oh,
And how are you then, Addie, my girl? What's wrong?
Nothing. I'm extremely well, Mr. Hofreiter. May I suggest that you address me with a little less familiarity? I don't like you calling me Addie. What's over is over. I like simple relations.
Oh, really, Mrs. Natter? I had the impression you liked complicated ones. Adela.
Wouldn't you rather watch the game, Doctor? Erna's particularly worth watching on the tennis court.
Can't you see, my dear friend, that she doesn't care 2 pins for me?
Perhaps the best foundation for a happy marriage.
Oh, yes, if I reciprocated her lack of feeling. But in this case... By the way, Frau Genia, is Friedrich serious about coming with me to the mountains?
I don't know. I was taken by surprise myself.
And what about this American trip? Is he going?
Yes.
Well, bravo, you'll be travelling together.
I didn't say that.
But you'll go. It would really be too silly for Korsakoff to have died entirely in vain. I'm convinced that Korsakoff was destined by Providence to fall as a sacrifice.
A sacrifice?
For you and your happiness.
You believe in that sort of thing?
Generally speaking, I don't, but in this case, I feel something of the mysterious connection between things. Hasn't the same thought occurred to you?
Me? I'm sorry, but I hardly think about that sad business. If only I were a nicer person. Perhaps I'll feel differently later. Perhaps when autumn comes, the days are too bright and summery for sorrow, or indeed for taking anything too seriously. For instance, I can't even be angry with Idella Nutter. It just seems pointless to bear her a grudge. We should be glad that it ended without mishap. We're both of us too old for youthful follies. My children are growing up, and your boy too.
What difference does that make?
If you would allow me to give you some advice, I think the way you're flirting with Mrs. Varl's little girl is frankly disgraceful. And for heaven's sake, don't think this is jealousy. I'm not thinking of you at all, more of your wife, who is really the sweetest, most touching creature I've ever met. When she asked me to bring the children round, did you hear her? I wanted the earth to swallow me up.
I assure you, it didn't show.
Truly, you don't deserve her.
I can't say you're wrong about that. Can't imagine what you're suggesting. Erna, a girl I've dandled on my knee.
Oh, what difference does that make? There are girls of all ages of whom that can be said.
Very true, Adela. It's not a bad idea. Oh, Addie, it'd be wonderful to be young again.
You've been young quite long enough.
Yes, but I was young too soon. These things are so badly arranged. Shall I tell you something, Adela? It really does seem to me that everything that has happened to me now has only been a preparation, and that now life and love are just beginning.
There is more to life than women to make love to.
Oh, yes. There are the spaces between them, not uninteresting. If one has the time, and if one is in the mood, one builds factories, conquers nations, writes symphonies, becomes a millionaire. But believe me, all that is merely to fill in the time. Life is for you. For you. For you.
And to think that there are people who take you seriously.
Good evening, Adela. How are you, Hofreiter, old man?
Why are you so late?
And what have you been up to, may I ask?
Forgive me, my love. I've been sitting in the park reading. It's the only chance I get. Tell me, Hofreiter, is there anything nicer than sitting under a tree with a book?
That depends.
On what?
The book.
What depends on the book?
Nothing, just idle chatter. Oh, by the way, Stanzidis, I was going to ask you to come to the theatre with us, if that's all right with you, Adela, my dear. I've taken a box in the arena.
Delighted!
Does that trash amuse you, Natter?
And why not?
There's nothing on earth that doesn't amuse him. My husband is the best audience anyone could have.
It's true. I find life wholly amusing.
Ladies and gentlemen, ice cream is served.
Me, I'm afraid I must be going. Thank you, dear Fraugenia, for a most pleasant
afternoon. Look, why are you in such a hurry? Give me a quarter of an hour and I'll drive you into town.
But...
What? Are you serious?
But of course. You will wait then.
You mean you're going into town with Dr. Mower? Now?
Yes, that's the most sensible thing. I'll put a few things into a bag and stay the night at the flat so that I can set off with Mower first thing in the morning. But, wait for me, Doctor.
But Friedrich...
Wait!
Why are you going away?
I need a change of air, a change of surroundings. In any event, I must get away from here.
From here? From me.
Very well, from you.
What, why? What have I done to you?
Nothing. Who said you'd done anything to me?
Explain, Friedrich. Please.
Now, I think it's not yet time to talk. My mind is still confused.
How can you be confused? Listen, you had his letter in your hand. You've read it, haven't you? If you doubted me before, which I simply don't believe, for God's sake, Friedrich. Since that evening when you had his letter in your hand, you must have some idea how I... Friedrich, some idea what you mean. What I feel. Oh, God, do I really have to tell you?
No, of course not. That's just it. That evening... Yes. Ever since then, I have felt... No, forgive me. Of course, you didn't mean to, but... I felt that you were somehow playing off Korsakov's suicide against me. Without knowing it, of course. And that makes me just... a little upset.
Friedrich, have you gone mad?
No, I'm not saying you took any pride in the fact that for your sake he... that you, so to speak, drove him to kill himself by rejecting him when he... Yes, I mean, I know all that.
Well, if you know it...
Yes, but the fact that it happened at all. Well, just think about poor Korsakov now rotting underground, and you were the cause of it. Oh, the innocent cause. Innocent in both senses, as I said. Another man might go on his knees before you for that very innocence, worship you, but I'm not like that. No. It's distanced me from you.
Oh, Friedrich.
I'd have understood it if you'd been repelled by him, but you were not. On the contrary, he attracted you. One might even say you were a little in love with him. Or if I deserved your fidelity. If you'd felt honour-bound to be faithful, as they call it, to a faithful husband. But I did not have that right. So the question I keep asking myself over and over again is, what did he die for?
Friedrich.
And you see, the thought that your virtue, that something so abstract, at least compared to the terrible and irreversible fact of death, that your virtuousness drove a marvellous man to his grave, that to me is ghastly. Oh, yes, I can't put it any other way. Oh, it'll pass, of course, this feeling. In time, in the mountains, and if we're apart for a little while. But at the moment, it is there, and I can't do anything about it. I know it must seem strange to you. It seems strange to me, too. Almost as though it's not me who's spoken.
Oh, it's you. It's you, Friedrich. It's you, all right.
Tell me, Miss Erna, before Friedrich comes down. Should I come?
To Lake Falls? Of course you must, Doctor. You and Friedrich must finish your walking tour at the hotel, and there you will find me, with Mama and my errant brother, Gustav. I'll engage you as our guide, for the usual fee, naturally.
I never imagined that I could lay claim to anything more.
You know I'm very fond of you. You ought to come anyway. It would be the best way for us to get to know one another better. But naturally, you mustn't feel any more committed than I do. Don't be hasty. I mean, don't go away after our conversation thinking that you owe me your fidelity.
You have it. Unowed.
What a gentleman you are, Dr. Maurer. I feel that if one put one's fate in your hands, one would have reached safety.
Don't think me a fool, Miss Erna. If I say that with me as your guide, I could show you, if not perhaps the best that life can offer, at least much that's worthwhile.
And to be frank, I sometimes feel that I need something more from life than security.
There's more to life than adventure of, well, shall I say, a certain kind.
I don't think I suggested a certain kind.
But I know your thoughts, and who can blame you? It's in the very air we breathe. But I tell you, I could show you another world where the air is purer.
You're not a fool, Doctor. I like your frankness. I like you very much.
Von Eigner, madam.
Good afternoon. Thank you,
Cathy. Mrs. Von Eigner, so late. I was afraid you weren't going to come at all today. Now I'm doubly happy that you're here. Come, won't you sit down, dear Mrs. Von Eigner?
Thank you. Thank you.
Shall we go to the tennis court? You enjoy watching Otto, don't you?
Ah, but it's not my son I've come to see. I've come to see you, dear Mrs. Hofreiter. Only, aren't I disturbing you? You seem to
me
a little...
No, not at all. It's just that my husband is going to town with Dr. Maurer. Actually, he's going away with him tomorrow.
Oh?
They're going on a walking holiday together. Just imagine, an hour ago he didn't know himself, and now he's off.
Then I've certainly come at a bad time for you.
Oh, no. It's not for long. We're not sentimental about being parted, believe me.
Yes, I see. But what about your little boy? Won't he be back soon?
Oh, Friedrich is bound to be home by then. Joey will be in England for 2 more weeks, at least.
You must miss him very much.
As you can imagine, Mrs. Von Eigner. You know what it means to see so little of your son.
I do, indeed.
But you have your career in the theatre and you're such a celebrity. It must be so fulfilling.
Yes, one would think so.
Isn't it? For a woman to be only a mother. It isn't right, it seems to me, sometimes. If that had been your only role in life, just Otto's mother, you'd never have let him join the Navy.
And if I hadn't let him...
Then he would have stayed at home with you.
I have the impression, my dear, that the opposite would be the truth. You see, he's a man. Even sons turn into men, and we know what that means.
Ah, I thought I heard your voice, the voice of an actress I know and love. How are you, Mrs. von Eigner?
Good evening, Mr. Hofreiter.
Do you need anything, Friedrich?
No, thank you. I'm ready. I'm going away, you see, Mrs. von Eigner.
Yes, your wife is telling me.
Yes, well, I'm just going out to find Ma. We'll be leaving in a minute. Forgive me.
Mrs. von Eigner, everything you say seems so right, so unanswerable. But aren't you being just a little unfair?
Perhaps so, Mrs. Hofreiter. But after all, being just a little unfair is the only justice we can get. Oh, I know what you're thinking. What does she want, this old actress? Her marriage broke up ages ago, and ever since, so they say, she's lived her life simply to please herself. She doesn't seem to have shed any tears for her husband, so what does she want? Isn't that what you think, Mrs. Hofreiter?
But, I mean, no one would deny that you had the right to live as you please.
Quite so. And I don't mean to imply that I still feel the pain of what happened. It was a long time ago. No pain and no resentment either. But I don't forget. That's all I mean. Think of all the other things which I've forgotten since then. Happy things and sad things, all forgotten as if they'd never been. But not that. Not what my husband did to me. That remains as sharp and as complete as it was on the day it happened.
Come on, Ma. I'm ready to go.
Miss Eleanor.
Come to Lake Falls. We'll see.
Oh, come on. I haven't got all day.
And I've come to see you both off.
Oh, very good of you. Look, say goodbye to the others for me.
I will.
Tell them it was Ma's fault. Tell him he wouldn't wait. There. Ready, Ma?
Ready to go. Goodbye, Anna.
Goodbye.
Yes. Goodbye, Anna.
Goodbye.
We'll meet in the mountains.
You aren't disturbing me at all, Lieutenant. I'm afraid I'm giving my book little attention. In fact, I was just thinking to myself that your mother might call. I haven't seen her for a while. Does she have a performance in town today?
Oh, no, she isn't at the theatre today.
It must be nice for your mother to have you with her again.
Yes, yes, especially since this is my last leave for some time.
Oh?
I've been ordered to a ship that's been attached to a scientific expedition doing undersea exploration. We are going to the South Seas for 3 years.
The South Seas. How romantic. I dare say that will give you scope for all kinds of exploration. Lieutenant?
Well, I think it's fair to say that in the Navy we undertake all sorts of activities which could, without offence, be described as showing the flag.
Just as I thought.
May I sit with you?
Oh, of course, yes.
And what about you, ma'am? Weren't you tempted to join your husband's expedition to the mountains?
Oh, I'm no climber. Ah. He is much better off with just Dr. Maurer as his companion.
But you might have gone with Mrs. Vahl and her daughter to await your husband at the hotel.
Weren't you tempted yourself?
I?
Well, since your father happens to be in charge of the hotel. Oh, forgive me if I'm touching on an intimate subject.
Oh, no. No, please consider yourself my... I mean, Frau Genia, I would be pleased to think that our friendship was one between most intimate friends.
As for seeing my father again, I can hardly remember him, and I can't pretend to miss him. But even if I did, I couldn't see him. My mother would consider that to be a betrayal.
Surely.
No, a betrayal, absolutely. Just as he betrayed her all those years ago. She has got over it, of course, but cannot forgive him.
Well, yes, perhaps because she truly loved him. And true love, the truest form of love, leaves no room for forgiveness. I'm afraid that I take a lighter view of life.
And love as well.
I'm learning to. It was nice of you to come to see me. The house is very quiet now, and I'm pleased to have come.
I'm glad you didn't go. Oh, Kenya. Kenya. Oh, the South Seas will not be far enough away to let me forget you.
Oh, Lieutenant. My brave Lieutenant. Aren't you afraid of getting out of your depth?
We've made it! Well done, Ben. You're a first-class guy.
We've got to go back down yet, sir.
Oh, even if we fall, it was worth it.
You mustn't say such things, miss. It brings bad luck.
She didn't mean it.
Yes, I did. Oh, Friedrich. Yeah. That view. Yes.
Give me a hand, will you?
What?
Well done, Ma.
Let's start down, shall we?
Lettlesbury yet, Porter?
Not yet, Mr. Serklitz. I was rather
busy.
Good
day, Porter.
Oh, welcome, Mr. Crindall.
Who's this? Well, it's you, my dear old Rosenstock. So you're at this hotel now. How will the Alpenrose get on without you?
I'm going up in the world, Mr. Crindall, from 1,000 metres to 1,400.
You received my telegram?
Of course. Oh, yes, you'll find numerous acquaintances here, Mr. Crindall, sir. Mr. von Hofreiter is here.
Know him?
Mrs. von Wahl with her daughter, and also her son who has joined them.
Yes, know them.
Dr. Maurer.
Know him?
Then there's Rowan the poet who's here resting on his laurels.
Ah, him too.
We had to put you on the fourth floor, I'm afraid.
Oh, fine.
Mr. Hofreiter has been on a climb since yesterday.
One of the big ones?
Oh, no. They were only going as far as the Hofbrandt hut. There were ladies with them.
Oh.
Mrs. Rohn and Miss von Wahl. Boy, take Mr. Crindall's bags to his room.
My dear Rosenstock, don't tell anyone I'm here. I'm going to give them a surprise.
Oh, hello, Paul. Porter, are they still not back?
Not yet, madam.
How do you do, ma'am? I thought you'd be surprised to see me.
I'm distraught. Anna has been out climbing since yesterday. She should have been back for lunch, and now it's 5 o'clock. I'm beside myself.
It's quite a large party, I gather.
My son Gustl's there, of course, and Friedrich Hofreiter, and Dr. Maurer, and Mrs. Rohn.
Well, then, nothing can have happened. Oh, by the way, please, ma'am, don't tell anyone I'm here if they happen to return while I'm changing.
Why?
Well, I'd like to surprise them, you see. In your case, I'm afraid I didn't succeed.
You really have to forgive me that today, Paul, with all this worry.
Yes. Well, perhaps some other time. Goodbye for now, ma'am, and don't say anything, will you?
Oh, dear.
Madam really need not be concerned. After all, the party took a guide with them.
A guide? Just to go to the Hofbrand hut? I don't like the sound of that.
Only to carry the haversacks. And besides, your daughter is an excellent climber.
I hope you're right. I just hope you're right.
Oh, my God. Look, I'm sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Serklitz, but the letters have not been sorted yet.
Never mind that. There's another thing. My laundry.
Oh, please, Mr. Serklitz, I have nothing to do
nor
with
anybody
laundry,
else. The maid upstairs tells me to go to the desk. I've been waiting for my laundry for 3 days.
I'm really very sorry. However, here is the manager, Dr. von Eigner.
Not alone, as usual. Dr. von Eigner.
One moment, if you please. My dear Rosenstock, His Excellency Vondra is arriving tomorrow instead of Thursday and requires, as you know, 4 rooms.
4 rooms, sir, for tomorrow? Mm-hmm. Look, how am I supposed to do that? I'll have to push people off the mountain.
Well, just be discreet about it. Now then, how can I be of service to you?
I can't get my laundry back, you see. I've been asking for it for 3 days. It puts me in an awful spot.
Yes, I see. But why don't you ask the chambermaid?
You're the manager.
My principal ears always go to the top.
Really, I have very little pleasure in appearing in this get-up among your countesses and dollar princesses.
Forgive me, Mr. Sacknitz, but we have no rules here about how one must dress.
No rules? Do you really think it isn't noticeable how different people are treated here?
My dear sir,
I will tell you to your face, my dear sir, if the King of England or His Excellency Vondra stood here instead of plain Karl Maria von Sacknitz, you would adopt a very different tone. Yes, indeed. The man hasn't been born who can get away with treating me in that high-handed fashion, whether he wears a monocle or not.
If anything about my appearance is a personal affront to you, Mr. Sacknitz, I am, of course, at your disposal.
Now it's swords or pistols, is it? That's a good one. Listen, I would leave this joke hotel, this Eldorado of snobs, swindlers, and stockbroker Jews, on the spot by special express, but for the fact that I don't intend to make you a present of my laundry. For the moment, I will go and see if it has been returned. In the meantime, your humble servant, sir.
I am terribly sorry about that, sir.
Signor, Herr Director, one can speak with you?
Delighted, signorina.
Good evening, madam. Well, aren't our mountaineers back yet?
They are not, Mr. Earn.
They'll be here soon. My wife would never dream of missing a meal. You see that very pretty girl over there? That's von Eigner's latest conquest.
What, her? You pointed out a different one yesterday.
It was a different one yesterday. What a man. You have no idea of the swathe he has cut through the district. Haven't you been struck, for instance, by the similarity between Eigner and the head waiter?
You think the head waiter is his son?
His nephew, anyway. Yes, the way he gets about, even his nephews look like him.
Oh, how can you be in any sort of mood to make jokes? They should have been back for lunch. It's 5:30 now. I blame myself for not going with them.
You're quite wrong to do so. It would only have made rescue more difficult and added to the casualty list.
I find your jokes in horribly bad taste, Mr. Rand.
Well, I am writing a tragedy. In verse. Still, they ought to be back by now. My wife, at least. I'm accustomed to being received by her when I re-enter the real world entre acte. We like to spend the interval together. Ah, good evening, Dr. von Eigner.
Dear lady, what a pretty brooch.
Oh, do you think so?
As charming as the well.
Tell me, is it really such a straightforward climb to the Hofbrandhut?
As I told you, a stroll. Oh. Even I could manage it.
Then why didn't you go with them, Dr. von Eigner? I wouldn't have worried then.
Yes, unfortunately, I have my hands full here. Mm. Furthermore, since the Hofbrandhut is about as far as I can go, I'd rather not go at all.
Very good. But a thought occurs to me. Doesn't the climb to your peak start from the hut? To the Eignaturm, I mean?
Yes, it was mine once, no longer, but no one else since either.
It must be an extraordinary feeling to sit at the foot of a peak one was the first to mount, and now to find oneself no longer able even...
Oh! So that's what it comes down to. They're all up the Eignaturm.
Why do you think that?
Well, of course they are. Otherwise they'd be back by now. Oh, they've got a guide with them, too. Dr. von Eigner, you're all in it together.
I promise you.
Isn't this a guide?
Where?
Coming towards us now.
Oh, yes, this is Penn, an excellent guide. Penn!
Penn, were you with the Hofreiter party?
Aye, that's right, Mrs.
Where's my daughter?
Where's my wife, Mrs. Warren?
Oh, say something!
When did they get back?
Where are the others? Why are you alone? What's happened?
They're all back here with me, Mrs. The young lady managed splendidly.
What do you mean, managed splendidly?
Where did you go, then?
Up the Eignaturm.
Oh, my God!
My wife up the Eignaturm? It's not possible.
No. The little fat one didn't go up. Just Miss Erna Hofreiter and Dr. Mauer.
And what about my wife?
And my son?
They waited for us in the hut till we got back.
So where are they, then?
The ladies and gentlemen came in by the tap room, so not to cause a flap. Excuse me, I must be off. Don't worry. Everything's fine.
All fine, you see. All fine. Now, please excuse me. Pen! Pen!
Did you notice that guide?
Pen, why?
Amazing resemblance to von Eigner. Amazing.
Mother!
How could you, Gustl? How could you let your sister go up that mountain? How could you have faced me if she'd been killed?
Out in India, one learns to be philosophical about these things, Mother.
I must go upstairs. I must see Erna.
Good evening, Mr. Earn. I must congratulate you on your wife. She plays an excellent game of dominoes.
You played dominoes the whole time, while the others were suspended between life and death? I'm not surprised about my wife. Women have no imagination. But you should know better.
Now, we didn't play dominoes all the time. At first, I tried to engage your wife in conversation.
About Buddhist philosophy, I presume.
Mainly.
My wife isn't interested.
Yes, I got that impression, too. That's why I suggested dominoes.
Since when have they had a domino set up there?
One can always find a domino set. On this occasion, one found it in one's rucksack. Mm. I never take a step without a set of dominoes. I've spent years in the study of the game.
Woo-hoo! Ah, here she is.
Yes, here I am again.
Oh, no, come, that'll do. We're not alone. Well, did you enjoy it?
Oh, it was glorious.
I hear you played dominoes.
Are you cross with me? I won.
Well, it's better than trying to climb the scenery anyway.
Do you know, I really was tempted for a moment to climb the Eignerturm. Only they didn't want to take me.
Now, listen, don't start getting ideas like that. I'm not going to have the pleasure of my solitude ruined by having to worry about you. When you're not with me, I don't want to have to think about you at all.
And that's why she doesn't think about you either, Rowan, old man. Take my word for it. You're going to get an awful shock one day. It was sheer luck that I wasn't your wife's type.
Tell me, Gustl, why are you so tactless?
I do it to impress.
Well then, dear, what have you been doing in the meanwhile? Did you get any further with your play?
End of Act Three. The audience rushes, deeply moved, into the bar.
It was the most wonderful experience I've ever had, Mama.
Nonsense. You've only been out one season.
Are you going to accept Dr. Mauer?
No.
Have you told him?
He knows.
Porter, is there any mail for me? Telegram?
No, sir.
Hello there, Hofreiter.
Good evening. Did Penn tell you?
He did.
Well, nothing has changed in the least up there. Not on top, anyway. The route's got more difficult. If it keeps on crumbling, it'll be certain suicide. You know, when you come to that overhang below the
side. I'd rather not hear about it. How did the little lady get on?
Erna. Simply splendidly.
Taking her with you, I must say.
She took us. I hadn't the slightest intention of climbing that mountain again.
Ah, there you are.
How are you, Mrs. Val?
I'm never going to say another word to you, Friedrich. Oh. What if she'd fallen? And I finished with Dr. Mauer, too. Where is he, then? It's quite monstrous.
But Mama Val, Erna would have climbed up with or without
you
us.
You should have tied her up.
But she was. We were all tied up together on the same rope.
It should have been a straitjacket.
Good evening, everyone.
Erna. Greetings, Erna. Oh, how are you? May I?
How charming to have one's forehead kissed.
Like the aged Liszt and the young lady pianist.
More like quite a young lady pianist with a not yet particularly aged Liszt.
Nevertheless, Erna, you should not have gone.
Yes, I should think.
It was wonderful.
Yes, it's beautiful at the summit.
I wanted to jump off. That's what was wonderful, that death should seem suddenly so completely unimportant.
Miss Erna, allow me to lay out my admiration at your feet.
Oh, hello there, pal. How are you?
Oh, God, damnation. Oh, I'm sorry. But isn't anyone surprised to see me?
Look, pal, it's much more surprising that we're here.
Well,
A letter for you, Mr. Hofreiter.
Thank you.
I hope it isn't bad news.
Guess who from? Mama. He's just received an urgent telegram from Vienna. Meant to leave immediately. He's gone. Asks me to convey his respects, etc. and so forth.
I thought it would be something like that.
So did I.
You think he saw us?
Probably.
Where's Dr. Mauer?
Oh, yes, he sends his respects. He had a telegram and had to leave at once.
A telegram? Mm. Dr. Mauer? That's odd. Someone's keeping something from me. He's fallen. He's dead.
Now, look, Mama Val, do you believe we could all be going into dinner if...
With you, one could never tell.
At the very least, we'd be dining in black gloves.
I gather from that idiotic young man, Paul Kreindl, that my former family has the run of your house.
Yes, one sees them from time to time. In particular, your wife has become great friends with mine. And I sometimes play tennis with Otto. He does you credit altogether. Perhaps he's a future admiral of the fleet.
You're telling me about a young man who's a stranger to me.
Tell me, Eigner, Have you really no desire to see him again?
Again? That naval officer has nothing to do with the boy I saw 20 years ago when I kissed him for the last time. It's strange to be talking about this today, after you've come back from up there. Do you know when I took on that climb? It was just after I separated from my wife.
Do you mean there was a connection?
In a way. I'm not quite claiming that I was flirting with death. There are simpler deaths available. But at that time, life didn't mean much to me. Perhaps I wanted to provoke a kind of divine retribution.
Listen, if every erring husband started climbing up the nearest cliff, the Dolomites would afford a very quaint spectacle. Anyway, you didn't do anything worse than a lot of others.
The measure is in the effect on the other person. My wife loved me very much.
All the more reason for her not to be so unforgiving.
Possibly, but I loved her very much too. That's the trouble. I loved her inexpressibly. Like no other woman before or since. And it was because I loved her so much and was still capable of deceiving her, well, that's what made it irreparable. You see, my dear Hofreiter, it left her utterly confused about me and about the whole world. After that, there was absolutely nothing on earth that she could count on. No possibility of, well, of trust. That's what drove her away from me. And I could understand that. I should even have been able to foresee it.
Well, that being the case, I have to ask why.
Why I betrayed her? You ask me. Haven't you ever thought what a strange, uncharted country is human behavior? So many contradictions find room in us. Love and deceit. Loyalty and betrayal. Worshipping one woman, yet longing for another. Or several others. We try to bring order into our lives as best we can, but that very order has something unnatural about it. The natural condition is chaos. Yes, Hofreiter. The soul is an undiscovered country, as the poet once said, though it could equally well have been the manager of a hotel.
The hotel manager wasn't so far wrong.
I enjoyed it so much. What an exciting evening altogether. I've never been to the theatre without Friedrich before. And of course, I've never been behind the scenes like this.
I hope it hasn't stripped you of your illusions.
This is so kind of you, Mrs. von Eigner. It is so interesting, but I mustn't stay. The Natters are waiting to take me home.
I always look in the boxes. I'm so glad to have a chance to speak to you, my dear. Otto has told me so much about you. I'm going to miss him. You know, of course, that he's leaving very soon for the South Seas.
Yes,
actually, I have the impression, my dear, that I'd be lucky to see more of him at home than when he's in the South Seas. What do you think?
What?
That is another illusion we lose sooner or later. The illusion that we can ever possess our children, particularly sons. They have us. But we don't have them, even when they're under the same roof. While they are small, they would sell us for a toy. Later on, for even less.
Oh, no, that's just... I mean, your son seems to me especially tender in his affections. Towards you?
I once told you he's a man. And one has to face the fact that even our little boys all turn into men.
Mrs. von Eichner... I really must go.
Yes, yes, of course. Do remember me to your husband when you see him again.
Oh, yes, I will. Thank you.
And is your little boy home yet from England?
No, Joey is still at school there for another week or two.
You must miss him very much. I know what it means to see so little of one's son.
Yes. We both miss Joey. But Friedrich will be home soon. Before Joey returns. Goodbye.
I'm sorry about Mara. You must have seen us from the hut yesterday.
One really oughtn't to roll around on the grass 50 feet from a hut with 20 windows.
Do you think it would have made any difference if he hadn't seen us? We wouldn't even have had to look at each other for him to notice. Just as the others notice.
What is there for them to notice?
Our feelings for each other. The way we're dancing.
Yeah, now, how can these people...
Perhaps we have a sort of lover's glow around our heads, like a halo. Must be something like that. I've often thought so.
It should have been me who left, Ella.
Yes, that would have been much more sensible.
You shouldn't be such a flirt.
I really am not.
I've gone mad since that kiss yesterday.
Now, careful.
Ella, I didn't close my eyes last night. I made a stink to do something madly foolish. I suddenly understand all that nonsense I used to mock in other people. The faithful vigil under a lady's window. The serenading of one's mistress. I understand how one might duel with naked blades for love's favour, or throw oneself off a precipice for love unrequited.
Unrequited?
Oh, don't deceive yourself, Anna. The whole thing. The moment up there on the summit, pressing each other's hands, the sense of belonging together, the overpowering feeling of joy. It's all just a kind of tipsiness, drunken altitude. What you felt was very little to do with me personally.
Why do you say that? I've loved you since I was 7. Huh? Seriously. And then yesterday, and today, and up there, and now.
Listen, Leona. I want to ask you something.
Then ask me.
All right. What would you think if... I want to get a divorce from Ginia and marry you. Why are you laughing?
Because you were only just saying that you were in a state to do something madly foolish.
Well, perhaps it wouldn't be if we just took it for what it is. I know you won't always love me.
But you will always love me.
That is more probable. Anyway, it's for eternity. What does it mean? Next year one climbs up another little peak and that's the end of eternity. Or another beginning. All I know is this. I know with absolute certainty that I cannot exist without you. Faint with longing for you. I won't be able to think or work anymore, occupy myself with ordinary life until I hold you in my arms.
You're holding me in your arms now.
I beg you, don't tease me. Look, just say no, and that's an end of it. I have no interest in making a public spectacle of myself.
I'm going upstairs.
Do you want to be my wife?
Wife? No.
Right. Fine.
Perhaps later on.
Later? What does that mean? Later? Life isn't long enough. I'm not giving you time to consider. A kiss like yesterday's is binding. It binds you to an immediate parting or to an unconditional surrender. I can't wait. I won't wait. Say no, and I leave in the morning.
I'm not teasing you. I know what our kiss bound me to.
Anna, think about what you're saying. If your door is locked tonight, I'll smash it down and that'll be the end of us.
It will not be the end of us. Haven't you always known that I belong to you?
Anna.
I love you.
So beautiful.
I think the moon has a lot to do with that. And you must go home, Lieutenant, or your mother will come looking for you, and I don't think my bedroom is the right place for her to find you.
Oh, don't tease me, Gania. Tomorrow, Frieda will be home.
Yes.
How can I see you?
You can come to lunch. We will have everybody to lunch. That's the life, isn't it? Lunch, tennis, motor rides, walks in the park, theatre. Love affairs. I used to take everything so seriously.
Oh, why don't you take me seriously?
You must go. The window's open. Go that way. Down over the roof of the conservatory.
I only wish...
What is it?
I thought I saw something down there.
Moonlight is famous for fancy. Now go. Quickly.
Oh,
Well, I must say, the welcome home luncheon for our distinguished host was first rate.
Yes.
What a pity he couldn't be here.
He must have been held up at the factory, Mr. Nutter.
Well, small wonder after 3 weeks away.
Did you telephone the office, Genia?
I didn't think it was necessary. I was sure he'd be back by noon, after yesterday's telegram from Innsbruck.
Have you seen what's in the newspaper, Captain Stenzidis?
No, what?
Read it. Please.
We have a report from the Lake Falls Hotel that a few days ago, a young lady from Vienna, Miss Erna Wahl, accompanied by two Viennese climbers, the manufacturer Friedrich Hofreiter and the well-known physician Dr. Maurer, climbed the Eignerturm.
Come on, pal, get
your racket. Known as one of the most notoriously dangerous...
Oh, yes, my dear Gania, those two dragged my Erna up mountains like that. I've never been so angry in my life as I was with Dr. Maurer and your husband.
The two of them took one look at Mama and packed their bags.
Yes. It seems that Friedrich's guilty conscience made him restless. I got a postcard from a different place every day. Caprile, Pordio, and heaven knows where.
You must be very proud, Mrs. Wahl, now that Erna is a celebrity.
Proud? Me? What is this paper, actually?
I don't know. I haven't seen it before. Who brought it?
There's an item underlined in red ink.
I wouldn't pay any attention to anything underlined in red in a paper like that.
But this is extraordinary.
What is?
During the past few days, a curious rumour has gathered force and an accumulation of detail in Viennese society. We pass it on with due discretion. Hmm. It concerns the suicide of a world-famous pianist who, at the beginning of the summer, was much in the limelight and then came under the shadow of what was not very satisfactorily explained by the hallowed phrase, a sudden brainstorm. According to the above-mentioned rumour, the cause of the suicide was an American duel played to the death, not simply with a black ball, but two white and one red. What does it mean? What is an American duel, Mr. Nutter, do you know?
An American duel is a wager between two people who agree that the loser will have to kill himself.
Not simply with a black ball, but two white and one red.
Well, the black ball would be a bullet, and two white balls and one red. Well, it must be billiards.
Yes, that's right. Friedrich was saying that he played billiards with Korsakov just before he...
But Friedrich lost that billiard game with Korsakov. If Friedrich had challenged Korsakov to a duel over billiards, it would have been Friedrich who would have had to shoot himself, wouldn't it?
Quite so.
Oh, that billiard game. Your husband did lose.
Yes.
He sent the cigars round to Korsakov at the hotel next morning. That's right.
It is unbelievable that one is more or less helpless against this sort of thing in the newspapers, especially as no names are mentioned.
Well, they're too careful for that.
I'm going to watch the tennis. Anyone else?
It's the same. How does something like that get into the papers? And why should Friedrich and Korsakov...
Mama!
What a good idea. Yes, let's go and watch the tennis. Yes,
Gustav. Otto, let's go to the conservatory. We can talk there. Do you believe it?
This absurd nonsense about Friedrich challenging Korsakov, of course.
But there could be something behind it in a word that I was Korsakov's mistress, too.
No, I don't believe it.
Why not? In your place, I'd believe it.
I swear to you, Genya, I don't believe it. Why are we talking about it? Who knows if we'll have another moment alone together? My ship leaves tomorrow.
Is it tomorrow?
How am I to live without you?
You'll live. It was lovely. But it's over. Pleasant journey, Otto, and good luck for the future.
Will you remember me, Genya?
Oh, yes. And I'll forget you, too.
Do you enjoy hurting me?
Why do you think me better than I am? I'm not better than other people. Haven't you noticed I lie? I'm a hypocrite. I act out this farce for everybody, for Mr. Natter and for Mrs. Wahl, just as for my own housemaid. I act the part of a respectable married woman, and at night wait in the garden for my lover. I write and tell Joey that he can stay longer with his friends. To my darling son, I write that. Just so that he won't spoil my fun. And then I write to tell my husband that Joey absolutely insists on staying on in England so that he won't hurry back either. And when he comes back today and shakes hands with you, I'll be standing by with a smile on my face and probably enjoying my cleverness. Do you find all that particularly attractive? Do you think there's a person I can trust? Believe me, Otto, I'm just like the others.
Kingia.
Friends, Romans, and countrymen, hello there.
Friedrich.
Good afternoon, Mr. Huffreiter.
Genya. And hello there, Otto.
When did you get back?
I'm pleased to find you're still here, Otto.
I was afraid you'd already be on the high seas.
I'm leaving tomorrow, Mr. Huffred.
So? Tomorrow? Well, excuse me. I must go and change.
You can't stay here.
Don't be silly, Otto.
I'm going to tell him.
For heaven's sake.
It's the only thing to do. Anything else would be cowardly.
I'll tell him as soon as you've gone. Tomorrow.
And what will happen?
Nothing, probably. I don't want you to come here again. Ever. Promise me. Never. Not even in 3 years. Never.
You love him. You still love him. I'm going to the tennis courts.
I'm not speaking to you, Friedrich, and I'm not speaking to Dr. Maurer either.
Have to see about that, Mama Val.
Oh, you mountaineers.
Now, where is Maurer?
He hasn't shown up at all yet.
Really? I hope he's coming today. I've written him a note.
Tell me, when did you arrive in Vienna?
Last night.
Last night?
Oh, yes, I would have very much liked to have come out here earlier, but unfortunately it was quite impossible.
We gave a luncheon party in your honour.
Yes, it was a great success, nonetheless.
Indeed. Well, I've had a cup of black coffee anyway, and there's another awaiting me.
You stayed away longer than you intended, my dear Hofreiter?
Yes, Mr. Natter, I did. How is everything?
Oh, just the same. I can't get my service right.
Good afternoon, Friedrich.
And did you continue to have a pleasant time at Lake Vals, Elena?
Yes, imagine it. Very pleasant, even without you. Oh. Incidentally, that really wasn't very nice of you to disappear so suddenly.
Your fame has reached the papers today.
We've already seen it.
You mean that newspaper has found its way here, too? Interesting rag, isn't it? Oh, now, where is Otto? Ah. Yes, I have to pass on remembrances, or more precisely, lack of remembrances. But I've spoken to your father.
Really?
Yes, it's a shame you're going away tomorrow. Your father wanted to come to Vienna for a few days. Yeah. That you should sail off into the blue without seeing him. It doesn't seem right, does it?
Perhaps, but now it's too late.
Well then, Lieutenant, our singles match, if you don't mind. I quite understand if none of you want to watch.
That's very considerate of you, Pa.
Yeah, most generous. What do you think, my dear?
Like you, my dear, most generous.
We might tear ourselves away for a moment.
Oh, well, of course. We're only playing singles today, Friedrich. You are not exempt. The Lieutenant is leaving tomorrow, and so the position must be settled once and for all.
I'm at your disposal when I finish my coffee, which at the moment is going cold indoors. Excuse me.
Oh, that's very well. I'm so glad to have you back, Friedrich. And now I'd like to know your reason for going away.
I told you. If I'd stayed, the whole hotel would have known about us. You know why. The sinner's halo, you called it, Anna.
Lovers.
Exactly. We'd done enough to earn it.
What if they had noticed?
Dear girl, that's not something to be given away to the world. And the less you think of the world, the less you should give it away. You should be grateful to me for not compromising you. Later, you would have come to blame me for it.
Later? Oh, I see. But I'll never marry Friedrich.
Don't speak too soon, my darling. You should never try to look into the future, not even into the next moment. Believe me. Oh, dear. Looks as though poor Otto is serving worse than ever out there.
And do you think that if I ever loved anyone after you, I'd be able to keep silent about us?
Of course you could. And you would be right to.
What's the matter with you? Why are you so nervous? Are you expecting somebody?
Yes, my friend, Ma.
Do you think he still is a friend?
Yes. Friendship is above incidents. These things don't depend on events. He could shoot me dead and it would still be his friend he'd shot.
Is that why you're so nervous?
It's probably that I'm just rather short of sleep. I was keeping a vigil under someone's window.
Last night?
Yes, last night. I told you that evening. I suddenly understand all those things. Serenades. Duels. Suicide.
I don't understand you. Whose window?
Well, yours, of course.
What a romancer you are.
You don't believe me? Listen. Yesterday evening, I did come on out here straight after arriving in Vienna. It was almost midnight when I was beneath your window. You still had a light burning. I saw your shadow glide past the curtains. If your room had been on the ground floor, who knows?
And then?
And then I went away again. Back to town. I'd been near you. That's all I wanted.
You were beneath my window. Oh, Friedrich.
Shh, 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 shh.
Look, Friedrich. Ah. Dr. Mauer is here.
Hello, Friedrich. Miss Erna.
I'm glad to see you, Mauer.
Good evening, Doctor.
Have you been back long, Miss Erna?
Just for 2 days.
I received your note, Friedrich. You wanted to see me.
Yes. Come on, I'll finish my coffee in the conservatory. Join me.
Your note said you needed my advice. I take it you're not feeling well.
No, it wasn't the doctor I wanted to see. It was my friend.
I see. Well, here I am.
Actually, it's about an absurd rumour which perhaps you've already heard about or read about.
Is that the paper? I hadn't seen it. Mm. I'd heard about it.
Well, then, what am I to do? Someone opened his mouth and put this libel about. I want to nail him.
Whoever it is, you'd have a job to find him.
As far as I'm concerned, I've found him. It's Nutter.
You think so?
It's his revenge. After all, he knew...
Everything, I'm sure.
Yes. There aren't anything like as many deceived husbands around as their wives like to think.
Well, there's nothing you can do.
I could accuse him to his face.
Naturally, he'd deny it.
Give him a good hiding.
That wouldn't help.
Might help my mood.
As a means to an end, it would be somewhat disproportionate.
I don't think so. A good mood is very important.
I'd let the matter drop. With the best will in the world, I can't advise you differently. For now, I'll be on my way.
You could damn well stay here. Oh, all right. I kissed Erna once. I don't deny it. A kiss like that in the open air on a beautiful day at 10,000 feet doesn't mean a thing. I'd call it vertigo.
Well, if that's what you'd call it, then everything's all right.
But do you think there are lots of unkissed girls running around the world? It's even been known to happen at sea level. A kiss for a chap to think he's too good for a girl just because she let another man kiss her, forgive me. But that's megalomania.
You get great pleasure out of lying, don't you?
Enormous. At times. But on this occasion, I'm denying myself. And let me tell you something else. Even if there had been anything more to it, more than this kiss...
I haven't asked you. And I assure you it makes no difference to me how far things have gone between you.
Oh, but it should, my dear Ma.
Oh?
Might have been better for you if we had become lovers. The affair would have been over and done with. In a way, you'd be more secure.
I'm beginning to find you amusing.
Just as I am more secure about Ginia and Otto.
I beg your pardon.
My wife. Ginia. Her affair with Otto. Oh, didn't you know? Well, what have you got to say about that?
If it's true...
Then it serves me right. I know. But let me tell you that your satisfaction is misplaced. For I'd have to find the affair hurtful. Or at least irritating. But that is not the case. On the contrary. It's more like a... happy release. I am no longer the guilty party in this house. I can breathe freely again. It's almost as if she's atoned for Korsakov's death, and indeed in a most rational and painless way. She's begun to close the distance between us as human beings. We are once more living, as it were, on the same planet.
I congratulate you on your poise. Clearly you don't believe a word of it.
I could be jumping to conclusions. All I've got to go on is seeing Otto climbing out of my wife's bedroom window at 1:30 in the morning.
What?
Yes. I came out here to Baden on the last train from Vienna. Walked here from the station and came, as I sometimes do, through the little gate into the garden. The house was dark, of course. But as I approached, what should I see? Gania's bedroom window opening. And a man climbing down.
I hope you're not thinking of making him and Gania pay for it.
Staff writer.
Ah.
Oh, good evening, Dr. Maher. How are you?
I'm very well. If you'll excuse me, Friedrich, I'll say good evening to your wife and be on my way.
Forgive me, Hofreiter. I just wanted to ask you, as Adela and I can't stay any longer, alas, if I could come to see you at your office tomorrow. That syndicate has shown up again. They're offering
business tomorrow, Mr. Nutter.
As you wish.
Today we'll chat. Sit down. Coffee?
Well, thank you.
Tell me, Nutter, what do you make of Demeter Stanzidis?
Stanzidis? Mm. Oh, nice enough fellow. A bit soft-hearted for a captain in the Hussars, but a decent chap on the whole.
Hasn't he got debts?
Well, not to my knowledge.
Well, doesn't he mistreat his subordinates?
Well, I've never heard anything like that.
Does he perhaps cheat at cards?
Do you have reason to think so, Hofreiter?
No, I just wanted to make it easier for you to get something on him later on, when his affair with your wife is over.
I'm glad you don't think me a fool, Hofreiter.
No. I think you're...
I warn you not to call me a scoundrel. I may not find it convenient to settle this business over a game of billiards.
There are other ways.
If I'd wanted to challenge you, I would have had better cause not so long ago.
So, you revenge yourself by reinventing these ridiculous tales about me.
It could be the truth.
God! Do you really believe that? That I would challenge Korsakov, a man like that? That I could have reason to? I swear to you that you are wrong. I swear to you
your wife's virtue.
Now, just...
Now, calm down. We don't want any fuss. I'm not going to brawl with you. But just one word more, and I might...
So, I am to be at the mercy of someone like you.
Someone who finds life wonderfully amusing, dear Hofreiter, and no more than that. Ah, look who's here. Your challenger in person.
Sorry to interrupt. Mr. Hofreiter, it's you and me now, when you've finished your coffee, of course.
Yes. Yes. I'm ready, Otto. Let the position be settled once and for all. I'll follow you in a moment.
Very well.
Once and for all. To the death, perhaps?
Why not?
Don't let me keep you.
I wish Joey would come home now. Oh, look, Friedrich and Otto are going towards the court. The duel is about to begin, but the sky's growing darker.
Gania.
No. No, please don't go yet.
I'm afraid I must.
I think I know what is driving you away from us.
I think you do not.
Don't take it too hard. It would be silly of you, who sees life at its most truly serious, to take seriously these foolish games. Well, that's all these love affairs are, Doctor, believe me. And once you've accepted that... They're very enjoyable to watch. Even to take part in.
Once you have accepted that.
You will too, my friend. And all those silly words that fill your mind. You'll see how empty they really are. They just blow away.
And only the lies remain. Don't they matter either?
Can one have lies in a game? That's called bluff. All part of the fun.
A game, oh yes. If that's how it was played... I assure you, Gania, I would have nothing at all against a world in which love really was, in fact, nothing but a delightful game. But in that case, let it be played honestly. This hole-in-the-corner love and this bogus civility between people made wretched by jealousy, cowardice, lust. I find all that sad and horrible. And this much-vaunted freedom one finds here lacks conviction. That's why happiness eludes you all, and why your laughter is only a mask for pain.
Oh, really? We all make an effort. Though, of course, it doesn't always go as well as we would like, but we do have the best of intentions, haven't you noticed? Adela Natter visits me. I chat to Erna. Friedrich plays his game of tennis with the lieutenant.
And why shouldn't he?
Oh, Doctor.
Yes. I know. Tread carefully, Gania.
Why? Tread carefully? Friedrich won't mind. After all, Otto might have killed himself too if I hadn't... Like the pianist. And one mustn't drive a young chap to blow his brains out over a trifle like one's own virtue. Friedrich will give me his blessing. Tomorrow, when my lover has gone, I'll tell him all about it myself.
That won't be necessary. He saw the lieutenant last night at 1:30.
Oh, no.
Yes. Friedrich knows.
Oh, wonderful match. The old guard lives on.
It was a fine game.
Yes. I don't know. You weren't on top form, Otto, as if your mind was elsewhere.
Well, when I return in 3 years, Mr. Hofreiter, I hope to be a better match for you.
I never look so far ahead. Anything might happen to make all prediction useless. And all prudence.
And prudence doesn't happen to be one of the lieutenant's strong points.
I'm only too aware of that myself, Mr. Natter.
Oh, there's no way you could know, Otto, whether or not you're prudent by nature. In a profession where so much depends on morale and discipline, as in yours, you can't know what your nature really is, don't you think?
It's getting late for psychology. Otto, shall we go together?
I don't doubt for a moment, of course, that you would be ready to lay down your life for king and country, Otto, but external conditioning plays a certain role in that. In the depths of your soul, in the very depths, you're a coward.
I haven't understood you correctly, have I?
I don't know what you understood. In any case, I'll repeat it. You are a coward.
You will hear from me.
I hope so. And soon.
Very soon.
Well, I think that's everything.
No, don't go yet, Ma. I hope I can count on you.
No, I'll have nothing to do with
it. As a doctor, Ma, you can't deny me that. It's your duty.
Very well.
Thank you.
I, too, am at your disposal.
Dear Stanzides, I thank you. Natter, can I ask you?
My dear Hofreiter.
I think we share the same view of life, don't we? Too funny for words.
I've always said so.
This latest joke would have one more twist for me, if you would be my second.
Only too pleased. The lieutenant is bound to be a good shot.
Friedrich!
Later.
No!
Excuse me, gentlemen. I'll join you later. What is it?
What on earth are you doing? How can...
Don't worry. I won't do much to him. Probably nothing at all.
Then why? If it had anything at all to do with your feeling for me, if it were hate, rage, jealousy, love.
That's right. I couldn't give a damn about any of that. But I won't be made to look a fool.
What's the matter?
They aren't back yet. Isn't there any news?
Oh, how could there be? Calm yourself, Anne. Nothing can happen till this afternoon at the earliest. I should think they're still discussing formalities. So I thought I'd just sit here in the conservatory and wait.
Yes, of course. You don't mind my asking. I know I have no right.
You have as much right to tremble for someone as I have.
I'm not trembling, Mrs. Hofreiter. I never tremble. I simply wanted to ask if you had seen your husband today.
My husband went into town yesterday evening, arranging various matters with his lawyer, by all accounts. That's quite usual, even if it is superfluous. He will settle his affairs, perhaps even burn some letters and papers in brief. Behave just as if it were a deadly serious business, instead of this charade of a foolish vanity defending a travestied honour, which is what we all know it to be.
I'm not convinced of that, Frau Gania.
I am. You haven't told me anything about your travels yet. You had an interesting time at Lake Voss.
Is it possible that you can mock me at such a time, Gamer?
I'm not mocking you. It's the last thing. You love him very much, don't you? Oh, well. It's only to be expected. There's nothing like the first time. Or doesn't even that mean anything nowadays? You must tell me about that, Em. When I was your age, one still took certain things terribly seriously. Now I don't know where I am anymore. Oh, by the way, Joey's arriving today. It'll be so lovely to see him again.
Gamia, at 5 o'clock this morning I saw Gustav leave. The duel took place at 6. While we're talking, it's all long since been over.
So everything's over. Now nothing can be changed, isn't that so? Then they'll all be sitting down together under the shade of a tree and toasting the reconciliation. Anna, do you think they'll be drinking our health? Why not? Perhaps they'll turn up here together, arm in arm. Yes, we should go and meet them. What is it?
It's Otto's mother. Oh, well, she's walking quite calmly towards us. She doesn't know anything.
What's she doing here so early?
She certainly doesn't know anything. She's quite unconcerned. Why should she know anyway? Oh, get a hold of yourself, Argenia.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's you, Mrs. Van Eyck.
Goodbye, then.
You're going? I hope I'm not driving you away.
Not at all. I had just taken my leave. Goodbye, Frau Gamia.
I'm delighted to see you again, Mrs. Van Eyck. Friedrich went into town. You know, of course, Mrs. Van Eyck, that he got back yesterday. Please take a seat.
Of course I know. Otto conveyed Mr. Hofreiter's respects to me last evening.
I see. Your son is leaving you today.
My son has, in fact, already left. He caught the last train yesterday. And this evening he's travelling to his ship.
Oh, this evening, is it? Ah.
Was I really the first to tell you that?
No.
Can you imagine, Mrs. Hofreiter, how I felt this morning as I sat down to breakfast in my summer house, once again quite alone? I wanted to go for a walk by myself in the woods. And now I'm here. I don't know how that happened. I had the choice of being very angry with you, or of being very sympathetic towards you. And when I left home, I was still far from decided. Because in these last few days, I have sometimes really been afraid.
Afraid?
I do know my son. And I've seen how much he suffered recently. He wasn't made at all for deceit. I was afraid for him. You meant so much to him, Genya, more than his profession or his future or me or his life. Oh, God, I was so frightened. And I kept silent. I had to keep silent. In all my resentment, my fear, my jealousy, I had to understand. You were so alone, Genya, and so much wronged yourself. And even if it hadn't been as good a man as Otto, I couldn't have blamed you. And now that he's gone, all my resentment and jealousy have gone too. And I only ask myself, how will she bear it? She, who loved him.
Mrs. Von Eigner, I truly am not worth such sympathy. I will try to forget him, and I will succeed. That is certain as that he will succeed too. You mustn't worry. There was no understanding between us. I promise you...
You are so good, Genya.
I'm merely practical, Mrs. Von Eigner. Only... practical.
Genya. Don't cry, Genya. You can see, of course, that my choice is made. I cannot hate you. We will bear his absence together. We're going to be friends, Genya. It's all we can be.
How do you do, madam?
Friedrich, I didn't hear you coming.
How are you, madam?
I'm well. Back so early from town?
From town? No, I'm just going there now. I've just been for my morning stroll. A glorious day.
You've had a nice trip?
Yes. Very nice, very nice. No complaints. Good weather, interesting people. What more could one want?
Oh, yes. I have to send someone's regards to you.
Regards to me?
You'll be somewhat surprised. Regards from Dr. von Eigner.
From your husband?
Yes, early this morning. Before I left the house, there was a letter from him, the first for many years. And in a few days, he's coming in person. A conference with the minister, so he writes.
He'll be minister himself one day, your husband. Altogether, a most remarkable man. We talked a lot together in those few days. I like him.
And he seems to have taken you very much to his heart. Yes. It's a strange letter. Almost touching. Oh, well, goodbye for now.
Goodbye, ma. And when your husband comes here, our house is naturally les amis de nos amis and so forth. Adieu, madame.
Goodbye, dear Mrs. Hofreiter. Goodbye to you both.
Everything all right?
No.
He's wounded. Otto's wounded.
He's dead.
You shook hands with his mother.
I didn't know that she would be with you. What was I supposed to do?
Dead. Otto dead? Murderer.
It was a duel. I am no murderer.
Why? Why?
Why? Because I felt like it.
That's not true. Don't make yourself out worse than you are. You didn't want to do it. It was a terrible accident. You didn't want to. It isn't true.
At the moment he stood facing me, it was true.
You didn't even hate him, and yet you killed him. You vain. Contemptible. Monster.
It isn't as simple as... You can't look into my soul. No one can. I'm sorry for poor Mrs. von Eigner and for poor old Mr. von Eigner, too, but I can't help them, nor you, nor help him, nor me. It had to be so.
You're lying. He wouldn't. He wouldn't.
You're wrong. He wanted it as I did. It was life or death. Him or me. Ah. Ma, you're here already.
There was nothing more for me to do.
Where is his body?
On its way.
Where to?
His mother's house.
I have to go to her.
Ginya, just a moment. When you come back, I probably won't be here. I can't ask you to give me your hand, but... Are we just going to say farewell?
What are you going to do?
Go to town. Give myself up. Nothing will happen to me anyway. I've only defended my honour. Perhaps I'll get bail, though of course they might suspect me of fleeing the country.
You can think of that? And he's lying dead?
Yes, I can. He's got it easier now. For him, it's all over. But for me, I am still in this world, and I intend to go on living in it. Please make up your mind. Which way is it going to be?
It's over. Finished.
Frau Genia, you can't walk that road alone. Allow me to go with you.
Hello, Anna.
Wherever you want to go, Friedrich, I will follow you.
Declined, with thanks.
I know it more surely than ever, Friedrich. We belong together.
You are mistaken. At the moment, you're under the spell of these events. Perhaps you're even impressed that I... But that's an illusion. It's all illusion. I'll fold up like a pocket knife soon enough. It's over, Anna, for us as well. You're 20 years old, and you don't belong to me.
You are younger than any of them.
I know what youth is.
It's not an hour since I saw it. It glows. It laughs. It has an insolence in its eye. I know what youth is. And I can't shoot them all. Stay where you are. Have as good a time as you can. Oh, Joey. He's returned.
Leave me, Friedrich. I love you. I belong to you.
I belong to no one on this earth. No one. Nor do I wish to. Joey, you've come home.
Arthur.
Come on. Let's go into the house.
Ronald Pickup played Friedrich, Maureen O'Brien, Gainer, and John Rowe, Dr. Mauer, in Undiscovered Country by Tom Stoppard, based on the original play by Arthur Schnitzler. Mrs. Wahl was Elizabeth Proud, Erna Wahl, Tara Dominic, Otto von Eichner, Kim Wall, Paul Kreindl, Stephen Garlick, Adela Natter, Oriel Smith, Mr. Natter, Jeffrey Beavers, Demeter Stancidis, John Webb, Mrs. von Eichner, Maxine Audley, Dr. von Eichner, Timothy Bateson. Albertus Röhn was Brett Usher, Mrs. Röhn, Joanna Myers, Gustl Wahl, Angus Wright, Rosenstock, Ronald Herdman, Mr. Serknitz, James Green, Penn and Korsakoff, Gary Todd, and Carty, Danielle Allen. The radio version of Undiscovered Country was by Jerry Jones, and the director was Martin Jenkins.